Welcome to my YouTube channel, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Valwa Kane, and you are basically watching my very new video series of Leadership for Beginners. So in this series, we are going to teach you 5 reasons why you avoid leadership. And then we teach you how to become a leader. And then we give you 6 important things that a leader should do for his followers. So get ready to learn the 5 reasons why you avoid leadership.
Valwa Kane, the Black Motivator. Meet Valwa Kane in his new video series, Leadership for Beginners, with Japhet Mavungu, an expert in leadership all the way from Congo Brazzaville. 5 reasons why you avoid leading, how to become a leader, 6 important things a leader should do for followers. Stay tuned and learn the art of leadership. Click on the link in the description.
You don't know that you can lead. That's a problem. You know, one of the reasons why people don't take the lead, one of the reasons why people are afraid of leading, is because they don't know that they can lead. The reason why I'm making this series is that I am a member of many English clubs in Ghana, and I'm not in Ghana right away, but I am on the platforms on WhatsApp and on Facebook, and I've noticed that they are organizing elections this last time. They are looking for the president, a new vice president, to take the lead, but they are having a problem of lack of candidates. I can't imagine where many people are, and we are in lack of candidates. That's a problem, ladies and gentlemen. Those who were there, they were working. So didn't you observe, didn't you have time to learn how they were managing so that you can take the lead? Maybe you don't know the importance of becoming a leader where you are right now. But let me tell you this, you are a Francophone. You are in an Anglophone country, you are learning English, and you become the leader of an English club in an Anglophone country. Do you really know the meaning of this opportunity that you are having, that you are neglecting? You have to take the lead. I don't care if you are a lady or you are a man. What you gotta do today is to become the leader of your English club. Just try to do something. Stand up. I can't imagine that you have been there for 1 year. You almost know everything, but you are incapable of taking the lead. That's not explainable. I don't know which organization you are currently, but what I know is that you can do something. You can identify a problem and get involved into solving that problem. That's what I believe. You see, when people are not informed of their potential, they don't go for it. They don't try for it. That's why you gotta know that you can lead. You, watching this video, can take the lead and become the president, the vice president, a secretary, or whatever in your community, your club, your organization, or wherever you find yourself in. That's number one. Number two, lack of vision. This is one of the problems that people are having. Why people are afraid of leading? Because they don't have a vision, they don't have a dream. They don't know what a vision is. They don't know how to get a vision. And when I tell you to subscribe to this channel so that you can learn all these things, because on this channel, I teach you a lot of skills, a lot of things that you will learn nowhere. So you don't know what a vision is. You don't know what a dream is. You don't know how to build a vision. That's why you don't become a leader where you are. This is also another problem. I will have time to make a video and I will upload it. In that video, I'll be teaching you how to set a vision for yourself and for the organization that you are. So stay tuned on this channel and you will never miss that video. Number three, you are afraid of being accused and hated. This is a negative opinion you have about leadership. A negative opinion about something will always prevent you, will always put a barrier between you and that thing, and you will never get it. You will never become it. You see how Patrice Lumumba and other prominent leaders ended up, and you don't want to end up disgraced like many prominent leaders. You think that if you become a leader, your life will be exposed to accusers and haters. So you don't want to be accused. That's one of the reasons why you don't want to lead. Look, it's normal to be afraid. but you have to overcome your fears. You've heard of the saying, right? Courage is not the absence of fear, but it's acting is part of it. So you are afraid, but you still go beyond your fears and you become a leader. If you don't overcome your fears, nobody will follow you and you will not become a leader. Indeed, nobody wants to follow somebody who is afraid of situations and afraid of people. So you have to become a courageous person. Courage is very essential to leaders. When you become a courageous person, then you can lead. Before we continue, let me ask you a question. Did you subscribe to the channel? If you haven't done so, maybe this is the first time that you are watching my videos on YouTube. Please hit the subscribe button just below right here and turn on the notification so that you will never miss my videos anymore. So number four, you think you are not good enough to be a leader. This is a negative opinion you have about yourself, lack of confidence. You see, there are many people who don't become leaders because they have a negative opinion about themselves. They think they have no skill, nothing to give to your followers. They think that leadership is made for a certain type of people and they are not part of those people who can lead. They think that you have to be a great speaker, you have to be more intelligent than everybody, you have to get money and you have to possess a lot of things before you become a leader. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrong mindset you have about leadership. Leadership is not about money, it's not about any of those things. What you have to do is to have the willpower to lead. When you have the willpower, you can learn along the way. So those people, they always want to sit at their back. They don't want to show up themselves. They always want to do things hiding themselves. They don't want to come to even help. They are afraid. They think they have no skill, nothing, so that they can lead. If you are a lady, you are a man watching this, meaning that you already have what you need in order for you to become a leader. So go out and become a leader. The number five reason why you avoid leading is you are too selfish to be a leader. You see, selfish people really have a serious problem. If you look around you, you will notice selfish people. They don't share, they don't do anything if they have no interest. They just follow their interest, right? If they don't have any interest, they will not help, they will not do anything. They will just see you. They are selfish. You see, selfishness is a character that we learn in our parental house. If your siblings don't give you their candies, when you also get your biscuit, you will not give them. And as time goes on, you develop this habit. It becomes a second nature. And you take it wherever you go, even though you travel. You take the behavior with you. And everybody can notice that you are a selfish person. If you are too selfish, you can't become a leader. You have to overcome your selfish first. Selfishness is a character that we learn, right? But the good news is that we can unlearn it. We can start thinking of other people's interests. We can start giving out what we have. We can start caring about others. If you overcome your selfishness, then you are ready to set goals and to achieve greatness that will be beneficial to you and to other people. So, ladies and gentlemen, those are the five reasons why you avoid leading. In our next video, we will be practically teaching you how to become a leader. So stay tuned on this channel and don't miss out that video. Thank you very much for watching this video.